Remember, the 1,000 subscriber special Q&A is still going. If you want to join on in, just join the Discord in the description below. Enjoy the video.
I found out the hard way that our planet breathes. Not just the trees sprouting up from the grass to be strong oak pillars that rise toward the sky above over the course of decades. Not the flowers that annually bloom to mark the beginning of new life and fertility in the land. No. I found it through something much more sinister. I decided to head past the boundaries of the woods. My friend was nearly kidnapped and was clearly under a lot of distress, and I decided to go there and find an answer. I knew it was Jack, but I didn't know anything beyond him rested there, waiting for someone or something to swallow up as punishment for not following the rules so mercifully it gave us long ago. I ventured deeper into the forest until I reached the Forbidden Mountains, stumbling on the mouth of a cave that seemed to beckon me inside. I did not know what I would find, but at the time I was so convinced that this was my destination, that my answers lay in here. I lit up a torch, the flame at the end of it sticking to the cloth that I tied against the stick, and then I stepped in. No matter how deep I ventured in, no matter where I ended up, I never saw an end to the darkness. Never a dead end. Only the throat of the caves luring me in further and further. And so I kept crawling through. The jagged rocks around me grew tighter as I delved inside, turning around only to realize that the light from the entrance was no longer with me. Darkness down there was such an overpowering presence that it actively beat back any source of light. My torch didn't feel like it was so much a glowing beacon as it was a ball of heat, constantly struggling not to become swallowed by the pure, unrelenting black. I kept crawling through, and at some point I realized something that shook me to the very core. The passage I had taken, it wasn't random. It was not the result of erosion that took centuries to cut through. The size of the room could have been so much bigger, and it could have been so much smaller. But it was just the right size. Great enough to fit me in it. I felt air flowing past me as the caverns breathed. My skin bled as the sharp rocks acting as teeth within it sliced me open, bit by bit. I only pressed on because I had a terrifying sensation that something far worse was behind me now, demanding I move forward and only forward, or else I am forever this cave's lost wanderer. Moving on until my own lust for blood overtakes me with nothing but the occasional rat to sustain me, turning me into a monster. I eventually fell into a chamber of sorts, a large, round room with boiling water acting as the floor, and multiple corpses around me. Many of them seemed in different phases of decomposing. Some looked like they had just fallen in seconds ago just before me, though that would be impossible. I would have heard them. Meanwhile, others were mostly bone. Flesh and rotten meat peeling off at a snail's pace, dripping into the water. I hissed in pain as the boiling water grazed the scars from the cavern's teeth, blindly finding my way to a safe spot away from it. My torch had gone out during the fall, and I was now blind. I have never known darkness. tears like I had in that moment. When you are outside on the surface, you always expect your eyes to adjust. The moonlight is there for a reason, and yet we always take it for granted. But here, all I had to guide me were the bubbling sounds of water as it oh so gently trickled down elsewhere. I began to crawl away from the boiling sound, keeping my hand above me, just in case if I was about to run into something and I ventured on. Eventually, the boiling sound was left behind me. After so many twists and turns, crawling around completely blind for what must have been days, I heard something. A low, droning hum. It echoed off the cave walls in a way that I had learned how to track down, and I quickly became desperate to crawl towards it. I didn't even care if it was something dangerous. I didn't even care if it was something that could save me. I just cared that it was something. I had wished that I had never crawled to down there. I squeezed through another opening, illuminated by the faintest amount of light in another chamber. And off in the distance, about 50 feet, I saw something grotesque. A giant pile of pale flesh, wriggling and twitching in different places. Multiple limbs sticking out at random, some of which were still moving and trying to grasp onto something. Robed figures were bowing down towards it, muttering something about an angel. And as they worshipped it, I saw one naked man approaching it, embracing it with wide open arms, and I can't describe what it did to him accurately in a way that words could do justice. You would have to see it yourself, but the closest thing I can describe to it was that he was emptied out. I've spent weeks trying to find out what word could be used to describe what I just saw, and nothing did it justice, but that's the only way I can describe it there. The light in the room then turned from a simple yellow torch color to a stark, threatening crimson that bathed the walls. The giant pile of sentient flesh grew bigger, and I could see bits of it trailing around the caverns like pulsating vines, extending all around it and eventually digging into the rock. The figures all stood and turned around, pulling away their hoods. They all looked like burnt vegetation, shaped to appear humanoid. They all began to shamble towards me, and I knew right then that I had to run. Something just told me that they knew I was there and that I needed to get out. I turned around and just bolted, praying that I wasn't going to run into a cave wall, and somehow I didn't. I crawled downwards for days on end, feeling that presence behind me, and eventually I escaped. Anatomically, it doesn't make sense how I got out. I was on a constant descent. I should have been miles underneath the ground, but I ended up coming out the same entrance I found a long time earlier. Around the same time of day, too. I won't ask questions. I'm out, and I'm alive. That's all I cared about. I don't know what everything I saw in there meant. I just know that it has something to do with Jack. And that whatever he does, whatever he serves, it is planning something, and I don't know what we are going to do if it comes to fruition. I found out the hard way that our planet breathes. And not only does it breathe, but it eats. It digests you, it blinds you, and feeds off of that unknowing torture, remaining a constant threat until you're lucky enough to escape or you succumb to its will, becoming another unfortunate lost soul devoured by it. Whatever that thing was that I witnessed that day, I know that it wasn't simply in the caves. It was the caves. And who knows how many others were fed to it that didn't have the same fortune as myself.
I'm sorry. I couldn't say all again. I don't think I could bring myself back there mentally. It was too much. Thank you. Is everything in the town okay? Yeah, water should be fine. No, I don't. I won't lie. I want blood. I am starved, and more than blood, I want the hunt. But the drink will have to do. No, I am not drinking from you. I'll find a pig or something. I'm sure the town can do with one less pig for the winter. But not you. I'll tell Dixon about this soon. I'll hand him the recorder, but you, please never go out there again. Because you were let go when I got involved last time. And if I am in danger out there, then you are far worse off, and we can't risk that. You alone aren't going to be able to do whatever you need to do out there. Just stay in the town, and we'll figure something out. We'll keep everyone in the loop. I'm sorry if I worried you. I mean, can't even think straight. But, yeah. I need to rest. I haven't laid down in a few days. Yeah, you were the first I came to. I'll just be in here if you need me. Thank you.